Hey guys, what's up? Tutankhamun here. In this video I'm going to benchmark Unigine's Heaven 4 benchmark on a single GTX 1070 paired with my Intel Core i7-860. The video is recorded on an external recorder, so what you will see will be pure performance. The CPU is overclocked to 4 GHz, 12 GB of system RAM, and the graphics card is a GTX 1070 made by KFA2. It is the EX model, latest NVIDIA driver installed, and also overclocked in order to boost at 2 GHz. Unigine Heaven 4 is of course a standalone benchmarking tool. As you know, I'm going to use the Extreme preset, but with increased resolution. As you can see, the Extreme preset only uses 900p resolution, so in order to change the resolution to 1080p and also full screen, the preset needs to be changed to custom, but essentially it is the Extreme preset only at full screen 1080p. And with this in mind, let's see what kind of performance we can get from this system. The benchmark is primarily GPU limited, of course. I'm starting the benchmark. I was getting 101.6 on my Core i5-2500K. I have not tested the Coffee Lake CPU yet. That's why I'm doing these runs, in order to complete my database. Thank you. Okay, we have 96.8 frames per second. I was getting 101.6 versus 98.6. Okay, the difference is only 3%, but still it is worth to note that even on a primarily GPU limited benchmark, the Core i7-860 did give us a little lower performance, still quite good. However, we can see the spikes in the frame times during what I believe are the scene changes. There are 22 scenes in this benchmark. Maybe the spikes are a few more than 22, but that's okay. The benchmark is running very nicely. The GPU usage was mostly maxed out, but we did have some 98 to 97 and some bigger dips, so at 90% GPU usage, as you can see. These were momentarily dips, however, and maybe they occurred during a scene change, I'm not sure, but all this combined gave us a little lower performance compared to the 2500K. I'm expecting the 8600K to be a little faster than both the Core i7-860 and the Sandy Bridge 2500K. CPU usage is quite low, as you can see. The benchmark is known to be a very GPU focused performance benchmark. CPU temps very good. GPU temps also decent. RAM usage at 3 GB, 2 GHz for the core clock throughout the run, and of course the CPU is running at 4 GHz throughout the run. No problems here. A quite interesting result, considering that we are talking about a GPU focused benchmark. Still, even the rest of the system can actually affect even slightly the end result of a GPU limited benchmark. I hope you find this video informative. Thank you very much for watching. See you soon.